G'day guys, James here, Pirate Camp Co. Now today I'm going to show you how we're going to install our behind the grill light bars, which go into here. It's nice and easy, but first we need a drink. Whoop! Yeah! Cheers! So over here's a little thing of tools we need. We need Torx star keys. These cars got those painful little heads. You need these bad boys because these fellas can be quite a pain in the ass. Never go straight, a little set of pliers. And of course you need your trusty flat and Phillips heads. And a couple little spanners, 10 mils, generally 10 mils. I think there may be an 8 mil in there, but we'll check it out. Right, hey, let's get some out. Then we unscrew these like so. Pull them out. Dig them out, done. So there's multiple amounts of these to pull out. There's 13 of these to pull out. So we need to pull this flap out as well. This piece and this flap here out. Righto, a little pro tip. If you get one like this where it's just spinning and it won't come out, grab your little flathead, jam it on, and just start winding him out. And that one will come out just like that. Just grab it, give it a little wiggle and pull it out. Nice and easy. Righto, now we've got all our little annoying clips out. All we're gonna do, throw that one over there. All you're gonna do is start trying to get this out. Bit of a pain, a little bit. Flips up like that, nice and easy. And then we just, basically that side come out really easy. And then we just get out under here. See, it's under this little air intake. So we're just gonna pop that out there. Boom, she's out. Put this down here in the hand of the trolley I prepared earlier. Righto guys, now we've done that, we need to give our Walter a pat. Hey mate, say hello, have a refresher, and grab our 8mm spanner and head over here. Now just in here at the back of the grill, there's a bolt on this side and there's one on the other side near the headlight. So 8mm spanner, just need to undo these all the way out. We'll take them most of the way or all the way out. Makes it easy to get the grill out. Rightio, now we've done that. In the front here, you need to try and sort of get on here and give it a pull, and it pulls out from this headlight. Come over to this side. Give it a little, try to get your fingers in there where you can. Pop it out. Now, down in here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 clips through the bottom here. So you've got to actually get in there and try and pull them out like that. And then you can see down in there after that, and you can see where all your clips are. Probably a bit hard to see on the GoPro, but we can get in there and pop the rest of these clips out. And just like that, we've got it out. So now we've done the crap bit, this is the fun bit. We've got this piece here, the factory bracing in the back of the grill. There's a screw there, screw there, screw there, screw there. Just gonna grab our Torx bit and basically and just pull all these screws out, nice and easy. So we got our 4 screws. Pop that bit off. That bit can now go in the bin. Now we've done the boring bit, we've got all the crap out, we're ready to go. We now get to fit our new bracket. Now bear in mind, the actual bracket is stainless steel. This one here was that prototype bracket, I thought I'd use that nice and easy instead of breaking anything out of packaging. So far, we've only found the Nighthawk Bushranger 13-inch LED light bar that actually fits in behind the grill and the space in here on the front of the radiator support. So we are working on others, we're waiting on a Steady brand to come in, and hopefully their new little slimline one may fit as well, but we'll keep you posted on that. Now, what I do like to do, I found easier, is if you actually fit the light bar to the bracket first, you can loosen off these bits at the back here to adjust it this way and so on. And what I do is I normally just, I sort of sit it in there. So these points here, they pick up. And if you see here, there's a factory dowel sticking out of the plastic. I line that hole up with that and I basically drop them in nice and easy. And everything fits up nice and beautiful. And then we just basically put our bolts back in. But you see here, it sits nicely in behind the grill. Just pops in, you put the light bar in, you just push it in between these two bits here. So if we have a look here, kick that out of the way. Didn't really work for me, did it? So if you look here, you've got these two bits here. The light bar just sits down in between that nicely. Beautiful fitted, it's a couple of mil clearance here. And to get up this end, you do the same. Make sure the factory dowel lines up. Put that in, line that up. And you put your bolts back in. Now, once it's in this position, you'll have these loose, so you can tighten these back up. You can loosen them off, so you just get the light bar where you want it sitting nicely, evenly between the space. These bits at the back here, you can loosen them and just rotate and adjust your height where it's sitting on the road. So you're probably gonna have to do that once it's all wired in. Just sit it up, give it a bit of adjustment, and then finally push it back in the end. Hey Frank, what are you doing? All right, so that is pretty much concludes this video. Once you bolt that down, put it back in. Do not forget, like I did the first time, to hook these bad boys back up. Don't forget. Other than that, thanks for supporting us. Thanks for shopping. We've got heaps of merch. We've got bloody caps. We got it all happening. We got stubby coolers, we got hoodies, we got tank tops. We got everything. All the support counts, guys. Thank you. See you on the next one.